Hi guys, Amores here. You are about to see some CorelDRAW 1.1 action. This is a software released in 1989 and is running in Microsoft Windows 2. Now let's save this masterpiece in EPS format and let's see if we can open it in Windows 10 using a more recent version of Adobe Photoshop. It should work. EPS format was created by Adobe, so it shouldn't matter if we generated this file with a software released like 35 years ago, as long as everything is standardized. And of course it works. Now what can I say? I think I need a new t-shirt. Let's go back to Windows 2, released in 1987, while checking out some other compatible software like IBM Current, the first personal information manager for Windows. As usually, we are doing this on modern hardware. This time is not that difficult to get Windows 2 running on something like an Intel 13th Gen CPU. Windows 2 is just a shell for DOS, and if we have DOS running, we are almost there. Almost, because besides a DOS bootable drive, we need to use SETVER, a DOS utility that will report a different DOS version for certain programs, including Windows 2, which expects DOS 3 or something close to this version. We can manually set what DOS version SETVER will report for a specific program, but for Windows 2 it's enough to list SETVER as a device in config sys, and the default settings will do the job. A special guest to this setup was a dying Kingston SSD with 1% life left. Or at least this is what the self-monitoring system is reporting. If you ask me, I think running Windows 2 won't be the last job for this drive. Anyway, I had to disable Smart to be able to boot. I use an SSD because I can find a good use for a DOS bootable partition anytime, like starting Windows NT setup from it. Otherwise, Windows 2 will run from anything, like a USB drive, SD card, literally anything. Whatever drive we choose for the best compatibility, we have to create a partition that works with DOS 6. And the best way to do it is to use FDISK and format included with DOS 6 boot disk. Once we have DOS running with SETVER loaded, installing Windows 2, it's as easy as decompressing all 5 or 6 installation floppy images into a folder. I recommend 7-zip for decompressing multiple floppy images at once. Then, as soon as we have all the installation files on our DOS bootable drive, we can type setup and have Windows 2 running in less than 1 minute. Windows 2 is compatible with the newest standards introduced in 1987 by IBM, like VGA graphics and PS2 ports. VGA graphics remained relevant as of today, so Windows 2 should work with any GPU with a VGA BIOS. I used a NVIDIA GeForce 7900 GS, which worked perfectly fine, and as a bonus, did the full HD upscaling that you are seeing now on the screen. Basically, with PS2 and VGA support, everything worked from the first try on this socket 1700 motherboard from Asus. I used a Logitech mouse connected to the PS2 port without any problems. This wouldn't have worked in Windows 1, which knows how to deal only with a serial mouse, but we can use the Windows 2 mouse driver in Windows 1 to get PS2 support. Windows 2 was released in two variants, the standard $99 edition and the more expensive with enhanced features, Windows 2/386 version, designed to take advantage of the newly introduced 386 CPUs. Today we are going to see in action the standard version, released in December 1987. 1 year later, this version was renamed Windows 2/286 to make it more clear for what type of computers it was designed. Not that we can't use it on a 386 PC, we can, but we will miss some enhanced features like running multiple DOS programs in parallel using 8086 virtual CPU mode. Also, a 386 CPU can address up to 4 gigabytes of RAM. Now, that was a concern in 1987 or 1988 when most new PCs had under 1 megabyte of RAM. As you would expect, soon after Windows introduction, Microsoft released Word and Excel for Windows. The DOS variants didn't really stand out at the time. However, Microsoft Word for Macintosh was a bit more popular. This is one of the demo documents that came with Word 1.0 for Windows. Let's save it and let's see if we can read it in Windows 10. This is our Windows 2 drive, and the document we saved earlier is inside Word installation folder / library. Oh, Word 1.0 comes also with a picture of Monique. Hi, Monique. Well, right now I'm using OpenOffice instead of Microsoft Word. Usually OpenOffice is quite compatible, but I guess not with Word 1.0 documents. My guess is that Office 95 knows how to deal with early Microsoft Word files. So let's run Office 95 in Windows 10. Is that even possible? Of course, we don't even have to install it. It's enough to copy all the required DLL files into the same folder with WinWord.exe. Et voilà, Word 95 is now running in Windows 10. Without overloading our current Windows folder with some older unnecessary DLL files. And I was right, Word 95 knows how to read a Word 1.0 document file. And if we save this file in Word 95 format, I bet OpenOffice can read it correctly this time. And yes, our file is way more compatible, and if I have to make another bet, online converters like I Love PDF can understand Word 95 format as well. Let's check. Yes, of course, it works. In fact, after this conversion, our document looks closer to the original. I can bet also that we can pull the same trick with Excel files, but maybe we'll do it another time. Right now, I want to point out that sometimes we need to use the SUBST command to get some programs installed. They are expecting a floppy drive and won't install from our C drive. ME Pro is one of those programs. Now back to Windows 2. Using a graphical user interface with icons and overlapping windows was enough for Apple to sue Microsoft. Apple claimed that the look and feel of the Macintosh operating system taken as a whole was protected by copyright, especially when it comes to certain icons. It didn't end that well for Apple. Anyway, if trying to copy Apple wasn't that obvious in the standard Windows shell, an alternate shell named File Explorer from PubTech was definitely trying to do this. Just take a look. Yes, this is Windows 2 and Windows itself, this shell. And programs like Word are running within DOS base memory, the first 640k of RAM. This is quite amazing. However, Windows 2 is not limited to base memory. If we use HiMM6 and EMM386, we can get 32 megabytes of expanded memory on a modern system. Well, 32 megabytes was an insane amount of RAM in 1988 when a 386 workstation with 8 megabytes was $80,000, which is about 50k in today's money. Thanks for watching, see you next time, stay tuned for the next video.